Hey everybody, MT Aviation Photo and Film here. Today I have my good friend from Lepp Aviation with me doing this video to help clear some things up. So what's the problem?
Alright, so I'm sure a lot of you guys, if you've been watching my videos, you've seen in the comments, whenever we see a MAX or a 737NG in my video, we look down in the comments and we see, is that a 737 MAX? I thought they were grounded. What's going on here? Well, here we're going to clear this up. And since you work on the 737s and have been to school for it, I figured you'd be the perfect person to help with this comparison.
All right, cool. So before we get started, let's take a really short, quick look at the 737 family.
So in 1967, the Boeing 737 took flight. The 100 and 200 series used the low-bypass JT8D turbofan engine. The 100 and 200 models are part of what is known as the original 737 generation.
In 1984, the second generation of the 737 came into production, the 737-300-400-500, with its upgraded avionics and new CFM56 engines, would become known as the classic generation.
And starting production in 97, the third generation of the 737 came to be, which we know as the 600, 700, 800, and 900, with its new glass cockpit and updated CFM56 engines, which is now known today as the next generation, or NG for short, which is one of the series we will be talking about today.
In 2016, the final generation of the 737 was launched, the 737-7-8-9-10, with its new high-bypass LEAP engines and airframe changes, is known as the MAX, and is the other 737 in this series that we'll be covering today.
The MAX, as well as some of the NGs, use an upper and lower winglet, which at a glance can look similar. The split scimitar winglet of the NG and the advanced technology winglet of the MAX do, however, have some major differences. Starting with a side-by-side side view, you will notice on the NG fitted with a split scimitar winglet, the lower winglet is longer and much more narrow. The major defining factor on the NG, however, is the aft side of both the upper and lower winglet come to a very distinct curved point, whereas the upper and lower winglets of the MAX are square and geometric. If we look at both winglets side-by-side from the front, we can also see another large difference between the two. The winglets of the NG are at a much greater angle when compared to the span of the wing, almost at 90 degrees. The angle of the MAX is closer to 45 degrees when compared to the span of the wing. Moving away from the winglet design but still on the wingtips, we notice another difference between the two generations of aircraft, that being the aft white navigation light. On the NG, there is a white nav light located on the aft side of both wingtips. On the MAX, the white aft nav light became a combination LED and is located on the right and left side of the tail, just forward of the APU exhaust. With this lighting design change, both aircraft now feature the anti-collision strobe light on the tail, but there are still some differences. The NG uses a single light, old-style filament bulb located above the APU exhaust, where the MAX uses a bright flash mode from the LED nav lights located forward of either side of the APU exhaust. Another difference in the tail section are the APU exhaust cones. On the NG, the APU exhaust duct is hidden in the tail itself, and the tail fairing is cut at a forward sloping angle. The MAX features a metal exhaust shroud that comes to more of a point. One of the last major noticeable differences is the engines. The NG uses a CFM56, while the MAX uses the new high-bypass LEAP, both built by CFM International. Besides the difference in sheer size of the engines, a few things can be seen while looking head-on. The CFM56 on the NG has a flattened lower inlet for FOD ingestion prevention. This design gives it an almost sideways uppercase D, or an oval look. The MAX landing gear was extended in order to allow the installation of the larger LEAP turbofan engine. From the front, the inlet is more circular than that of the NG. If the engine is not spinning, you can see the difference between the CFM56 and its straight metal blades on the NG versus the LEAP's curved composite blades of the MAX. Another difference in relation to the engine is the thrust reversal translating cowl. The NG uses a straight trailing edge on the aft side of the engine cowl. The MAX features a chevron or scalloped trailing edge on the aft side of the engine cowling. This aids in reducing engine noise.
So hopefully this video helped point out some of the differences between the next gen and the MAX. And it makes it easier for plane spotters or people watching spotting videos to visually tell the difference between the two. Feel free to comment if you guys have any questions or helpful tips below, and thank you guys so much for watching.